In business, Absa Bank is set to intensify its focus on sustainability, pledging to double its sustainable financing to 120 billion shillings by the end of 2025. Speaking during the bank's sustainability report launch, Absa Bank CEO Abdi Mohamed and Chairman Charles Moshene noted that the bank had disbursed some 60 billion shillings in 2023 towards sustainable projects. Jimmy Mbogo now takes us through those impact-led investments.
In 2023, Absa Bank finance portfolio saw them invest over 60 billion shillings in key sustainability-linked initiatives. 22.3 billion shillings of which was disbursed towards climate finance in renewable energy, green building and agriculture. A further 21 billion shillings went towards startups and youth through the Timiza platform, while MSMEs in various economic sectors received a total of 11 billion shillings. Women in business took away 4.9 billion shillings. It is this portfolio that the lender intends to double by the end of the next calendar year.
Sustainable finance is a big area. Our target is to double the 60 billion number to 120 billion, and that's something that we'll continue focusing on. Engagements with our community is another important area. Fast tracking our own net zero ambitions. And this is back to that first pillar I said, as APSA.
We believe that we've got to set the tone at the top and set the right tone. Because if that tone is not right, then the impacts that we desire and aspire to achieve might not be achieved.
The bank's collaboration with Safaricom, which helped secure a 15 billion shilling sustainability-linked loan, has also been lauded. An effort that the Ministry of Environment and Forestry noted as a critical role that can be played by financial sector in pushing for responsible investments.
Banks are not merely financial intermediaries, they are the lifeblood of our economy. They influence the flow of our capital, the creation of jobs, and the growth of industries. But perhaps more importantly, in today's context, they have the power to shape the future by steering resources towards sustainable and reasonable, responsible investments.
We do foresee a situation in the future where, increasingly financial institutions will begin to reward people who are doing more environmentally, sensitive, projects. So that, for instance, if you're borrowing, you're a construction firm and you're putting up a green building, we should be able in the coming future to give you competitive rates.
By doubling its sustainable finance target, the bank is setting the tone for how the financial sector can contribute to a more sustainable and inclusive economy, even as financial muscle remains at the center of sustainability for most corporate entities. Jimmy Mbogo, Citizen TV, Nairobi.